Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to explain about implementation of stack operations using linked list. As we know that we can implement the stack operation by using both arrays and linked list. Already we have seen implementation of stack operations using arrays. Now let's see the implementation of stack operations using linked list. We can easily implement by using linked list and it allocates the memory dynamically. Here there is no wastage of memory in linked list. Stack is a data structure to which a data can be added by using push method and can be removed by using pop method. Linked list contains node class with two values, one is data and another one is the address of the next node element. Here, this is the stack with four nodes. Every node contains two values, one is node data and another one is next. Here, next stores the address of next node. And the last node is the topmost value of the stack. The topmost node in the stack always contains null in its address field. Now let's see the example for stack using linked list. Firstly, this is the stack with three elements 8, 45 and 10. 10 is the top of the stack. In every linked list, head is the first node. As we are having three elements in the stack, three nodes are required in the linked list. The first node is the top of the stack with two values, one is 10 and another one is 4500. It is the address of next node. The next node contains two values, one is 45 and another one is 7000. It is the address of next node. And the last node with two values, one is 8 and another one is null. Every topmost node in the stack always contains null in its address field. Here, the arrow marks indicates the links between the two nodes. So, this is a simple example for stack using linked list. Now, let's see the coding for implementation of stack operations using linked list. These two are the header files and void push, void pop, void display. These are the operations of stack. Firstly, we have to create the node in the linked list. And struct is used to store the multiple related items. We know that node contains two values, one is data and another one is next. Here the data is taken as an integer value. Struct node pointer next. Pointer is used to store the address of the next node. So node is successfully created with one integer value and address value. Struct node pointer head. For every linked list, head is the first node. So head also created here. Void main int choice. User have to choose the choice. Printf stack operations using linked list. It just prints the stack operations using linked list. While of choice not equal to 4. Printf choose one from the below options. And the options are printf, push, pop, show, exit. Show is the display. Printf, enter your choice. Scanf, percentile choice. Here, user have to choose the choice and enter the choice. Switch statement is used to test the cases. Here the cases are stack operations. Case 1, push. Case 2, pop. Case 3, display. Case 4, printf exiting. Case 4 is used to exit from the stack. Break statements are used here. Without break, the program continues to the next labeled statement. And the default statement is used for none of the statement in the switch body get executed. So, if user enters any other choice, then it returns please enter valid choice. It prints by defaultly. Next is void push int value. The first value in the node is data. The data will be the integer value only. After the integer value, we have to store the address of the next node. So memory is allocated to the address field. Next, if ptr equal to null, printf not able to push the element, which means this is the top of the stack and there is no place in the stack, so we can't push the element into the stack. If ptr equal to equal to null, if it is false, then it jumps to else statement. Printf, enter the value. We have to enter the value. If head equal to equal to null, pointer of value equal to value, pointer of next is equal to null, head is equal to pointer, which states that node with two values has successfully inserted into the stack. If head equal to equal to null is false, it jumps to else statement. Head equal to equal to null states that no nodes are present in the stack. If it is false, then it says that already nodes are present in the stack. If head equal to null false, it jumps to else statement. Pointer of value equal to value. Pointer of next equal to head. Head equal to pointer. Next node is created successfully, means inserted successfully. Likewise, number of nodes are inserted into the stack and it prints item pushed. For number of nodes, insertion is successful. Next is void pop. Deletion operation. Int item. We have to delete the node, so we have to enter the two values, one is data and another one is address field. Int item struct node pointer, if head equal to null, printf underflow. Here we can't delete any elements or any nodes from the stack, so it prints underflow. Head equal to null, if it is true, it prints underflow. If it is false, it jumps to else statement. Item equal to head of value. Ptr equal to head. One value is dead. Head equal to head of next, free of ptr. One node is completely deleted from the stack. To remove any node from the stack, firstly we have to make the removing node as head. Value is deleted, address field also deleted, complete node is deleted and it prints item popped. Next is display, void display. Int I is the remaining data values in the nodes. Struct node pointer is address fields in the remaining nodes. Pointer equal to head, if pointer equal to null, printf stack is empty, then we can't display the elements or nodes. Then it jumps to else statement. It prints printing stack elements. While ptr not equal to null states that the node contains integer value and the address field, and prints percentile d ptr of value and ptr equal to ptr of next, which means the two values are displayed. Likewise, all the nodes in the stack are displayed. This is the program for implementation of stack operations using linked list. Let's see the output. It prints stack operations using linked list. User have to choose the options push, pop, show, exit. I want to insert the values, so I choose 1. I want to enter the value 3. It prints item push and again gives choices to the user. Again I want to push the value, so I enter option 1. I want to enter the value 5. Item pushed. Again it gives options to the user. Again I want to insert the element. I choose 1. Enter the value 9. Item pushed. Enter your choice. Now I want to delete here. It prints item popped. Again, options are shown here. Now I want to display. So I choose 3. We can see here printing stack elements 5 and 3. These are the elements. It displays the remaining elements in the stack. Now I want to exit. So enter 4. See here, exiting. And this is the output for implementation of stack using linked list. Here we can't give address values as input, because for every value itself contains some address values, and those are not displayed also. Next is applications of stacks. Balancing of parentheses. To balance the unbalanced parentheses or brackets, we use stacks. We can see the example. There is no closed bracket. It is unbalanced. So we can balance by using stack. Infix to postfix conversion. Infix means the operator should be present in between two operands. Postfix means after the operands, operators are present. Given example, 2 plus 3 into 4. This is the infix equation. We are converting into postfix, that is 2, 3, 4 into plus. This is a conversion to postfix equation. Next is postfix evaluation. Example, the given equation is 1, 2, 3 plus plus, and it is converted to postfix. Sorry, it is converted as infix equation. For forward and backward features in web browser, stacks are very useful, and in tree traversal problems, stacks are useful. So these are the applications of stacks. So this is about stacks. I think this is very useful. Thank you very much.